church, he opened his mouth. The Lord filled him with the spirit of wisdom and understanding, and clothed him in a robe of glory. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Today we celebrate the feast day of St. Ambrose. St. Ambrose, bishop and doctor of the church, he's considered one of the four great doctors of the church, which means that Lord gave him particularly wisdom and insight to share about aspects of our faith that no one had gone so deep into. So some of these great doctors of the church, people like St. Augustine, St. Thomas Aquinas, St. Catherine of Siena, there's these different, St. Therese is one of them as well, and St. Ambrose. St. Ambrose is one of those that really powerfully defended the truth that Jesus Christ is not just a superman, not just a really powerful human person, but he's divine and that he's God. And that makes all the difference, because if Jesus Christ is not God, then he can't forgive us of our sins. And if he died on the cross and wasn't God and was only a man, then we're still in our sins. And as St. Paul would say, we're the most pitiable of people. But because Jesus Christ is fully God and fully man, he's able to die and yet have the power to destroy death himself. So that's the difference that that makes. St. Ambrose is also one who was instrumental in St. Augustine's conversion. St. Augustine went as a pagan, as a fallen away Christian, and he listened to St. Ambrose because St. Ambrose was a powerful philosopher as well. And he liked to hear St. Ambrose speak, even though he didn't believe what he believed about Christianity. But little by little, hearing the wisdom of St. Ambrose, he moved his own heart to want to give it over to Christ. St. Ambrose baptized St. Augustine. So a very important saint. Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who made the Bishop St. Ambrose a teacher of the Catholic faith and a model of apostolic courage, raise up in your church men after your own heart to govern her with courage and wisdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The desert and the parched land will exult. The steppe will rejoice and bloom. They will bloom with abundant flowers and rejoice with joyful song. The glory of Lebanon will be given to them, the splendor of Carmel and Sharon. They will see the glory of the Lord and the splendor of our God. Strengthen the hands that are feeble. Make firm the knees that are weak. Say to those whose hearts are frightened, be strong, fear not. Here is your God. He comes with vindication, with divine recompense. He comes to save you. They will be the eyes. Then will the eyes of the blind be opened, and the ears of the deaf be cleared. Then will the lame leap like a stag, and the tongue of the mute will sing. Streams will burst forth in a desert, and rivers in a steppe. The burning lands will become pools, and the thirsty grounds, springs of water. The adobe, where jackals lurk, will be a marsh and reed and epius. The highway will be there, called the Holy Way. No one unclean may pass over it, nor fools go astray on it. No lion will be there, nor beast of prey go up to be met upon it. It's for those to journey to make, and on it redeemed will walk. Those whom the Lord had ransomed will return and enter Zion singing, crowned with everlasting joy. They will meet with joy and gladness, sorrow and mourning will flee. The word of the Lord. The responsorial is, our God will come to save us. Our God will come to save us. I will hear what God proclaims, the Lord, for he proclaims peace to his people. Near indeed is his salvation to those who fear him, glory dwelling in our land. Our God will come to save us. Kindness and truth shall meet, justice and peace shall kiss. Truth shall spring out of the earth, and justice shall look down from the heaven. Our God will come to save us. The Lord himself will give his benefits, and our land shall yield its increase. Justice shall walk before him, and salvation along the way of his steps. Our God will come to save us.
Jesus was teaching. Pharisees and teachers of the law, who had come from every village of Galilee and Judea and Jerusalem, were sitting there. The power of the Lord was with him for healing. And some men brought on a stretcher, a man who was paralyzed. And they were trying to bring him in and set him in his presence, but not finding a way to bring him in because of the crowd, they went up on the roof and lowered him on the stretcher through the tiles into the middle in front of Jesus. When Jesus saw their faith, he said, "As for you, your sins are forgiven." Then the scribes and Pharisees began to ask themselves, "Who is this who speaks blasphemies? Who but God alone can forgive sins?" Jesus knew their thoughts and said to them in reply, "What are you thinking in your hearts? Which is easier to say, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or to say, 'Rise and walk'? But that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins," he said to the one who was paralyzed, "I say to you, rise, pick up your stretcher, and go home." He stood up immediately before them, picked up what he had been lying on, and went home, glorifying God. Then astonishment seized them all, and they glorified God. And struck with awe, they said, "We have seen incredible things today." The Gospel of the Lord. I was reading today a homily, or actually a letter by St. Ambrose, and he talks about this part in Scripture. It's not in the readings that we spoke of specifically, but it's this phrase, the rivers have lifted up their voice. It's something that we see in the Psalms, but in this first reading, you can kind of see this, the sense of the way that a desert starts to bloom is always going to be because there's water there. There's no water, there's no way that there could be any kind of blooming. So that's what we hear about. The desert and the parched land will exalt. The steppe will rejoice and bloom. They will bloom with abundant flowers. Streams will burst forth in the desert. Burning sands will become pools. We hear this beautiful image of life, fertility coming into the stark desert. So this image of the waters have lifted up their voice. St. Ambrose says, that is when someone is given to drink of Christ, the living water. Christ himself is that living water, and his voice is a voice, that word that goes forth, and it brings healing, makes the mute be able to speak, the deaf be able to hear, the lame, just like we heard the word of God, saying, your sins are forgiven, and rise, pick up your mat and go home. It was an effective word. It was a word that did exactly what it said. His sins were forgiven, which was invisible. And some of the leaders at that time were saying, who but God alone can forgive sins? In other words, you're saying, Jesus of Nazareth, that you are God. And he doesn't deny it, but he says, well, tell me, which one is easier? And in a certain sense, it's a trick question, because ultimately, the forgiveness of sins is such a deeper healing, and only God can do that. But he says, so that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins. Do you see what he's saying here? He's saying, I am equal to my Father because only God can forgive sins, and yet I am forgiving this person's sins. I'm not doing it in someone else's name, but I'm doing it because of my own authority as being the only begotten Son of God. And so he says, but to show you, I say to you as well, rise, pick up your mat and go home. Again, it's that word. It says here also that he was, it's very interesting. It says, then the power of the Lord was with him for healing. Jesus is the Lord, so what does this mean? It's this beautiful relationship of the Holy Spirit, who is another person of the Holy Trinity, always present, always abiding perfectly within Jesus Christ. It's not something in which Jesus was kind of walking along and then the Holy Spirit kind of came and now he's sort of supercharged. He always, from the very moment of the incarnation, he always was united perfectly with the Holy Spirit. And yet there's this revealing here of saying that Jesus is the anointed one. He's the one that is soaked with the Spirit. He's empowered with the Spirit. And so we see here the Father who is bringing forth the Word of God and also the Spirit of God. The two of them are beautifully working in this mission to bring us the water of living, the living waters that bring life in the desert. And so Jesus is not doing this on his own, but he's doing it always with the Spirit. And whenever the Spirit is there, that means that the communion of the Father and the Son is there perfectly as well. So it's the Trinity bringing forth living water in the desert. And this gift of God is a gift that God wants to give to each of us. the beautiful gift of the giving of the Spirit that brings life in the desert is it's not merely just one gift among others, but it's the gift of God giving himself. So when we think of the greatest gift, when you receive the Spirit of God, it's God giving himself to you. Just invite you to really think about that. It's not merely a gift among other gifts, but God giving himself to you. And that brings fruit. That brings the fruit that comes in the desert. We think again this image of the waters lifting up their voice. When we allow the water to come deep within our own life, it rises within us. And think about a river that has all of that minerals in it, the silt, that when it overflows, it actually brings minerals all across this plain. And there are so many fertile things that can grow in the midst of that. So many kinds of plants that need that silt to be overflowing from the river, going into all the surrounding area. And though it may seem, in a certain way, destructive, but in the larger sense, it brings up an even greater fruit. And that's what the Lord wants to do within our own lives. He wants the Spirit of God to come within us in such a way that the river of our heart just overflows with the water of life that brings that fertilizer, that brings that silt, that can bring such fruit into so many persons' lives. And a perfect example of this is St. Ambrose himself, who through being filled with the Holy Spirit was able to share that in such a way that St. Augustine was able to hear that word and he was able to respond to it and be baptized. And then all of those that he brought to the faith. We see in the gospel here the four men who are carrying their friend on a stretcher. Because of their deep love of God, their faith, which means that they were trusting in God, the fruit came to this man because of their faith. Jesus then looks at him and says, as for you, your sins are forgiven. There's a powerful mystery here of when we live our lives in holiness and allow the river of life to overflow within our own lives, such fruit, unexpected fruit, can come forth. So allow the gift of God himself to be received by you in a deep and fresh anointing. Every time you receive Holy Communion, ask the Holy Spirit to, in a sense, break open that seed of faith so that it can blossom, so that it can overflow and bring all of that silt to the surrounding area, your own circle of influence, your family, your friends, all of those that you happen to encounter today. Allow the Eucharist to, in a sense, pour over into all of your relations. And now let us stand and bring our petitions before the Lord. For the Church throughout the world, may she grow in faith, hope, and charity in her ministry. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For governments and world leaders, may the Advent message of hope in a new world inform and direct their decisions and actions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who struggle to find meaning and direction in their lives, may the peace of Christ be a light and hope for them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us as we journey through this season of Advent, may the Holy Spirit continue to transform our hearts to that of Christ's. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For for those who have died marked with the sign of faith. May they enter into eternal life with God. Pray in a special way for the repose of the soul of Camille Oliver Hoffman. Let us pray to the Lord. It's important for us also to pray for one of our Marian priests who passed away this past evening, Father Walter Gergel. You remember Father Walter, he was here at St. Mary's for many, many years, and so he passed away. I believe he was close to his 90s or so. So if you can pray for him and just that he might rest in that beautiful reward of eternal life. He was a very faithful priest. He was a priest that definitely loved to bring people Jesus. And so we just pray for him and for his family as well. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the intention of our Holy Father, Pope Francis, during this month of December. We pray that our personal relationship with Jesus Christ be nourished by the Word of God and a life of prayer. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we ask all of this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. As we celebrate the divine mysteries, O Lord, we pray, may the Holy Spirit fill us with that light of faith by which he constantly enlightens St. Ambrose for the spreading of your glory. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation. That when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. The Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." Supper was ended. He took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her into the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Ronald, our Bishop, and all the clergy, remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Ponders the law of the Lord day and night will yield fruit in due season. gifts who have been strengthened by the power of the sacrament, O Lord, so to profit from the teaching of St. Ambrose, that hastening fearlessly along your paths, we may be prepared for the delights of the eternal banquet. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So just a reminder that tomorrow is the beautiful solemnity of the Immaculate Conception. This year, because of just the particulars of this year, it's not a day of obligation, though it's a very beautiful, beautiful feast day. And we do have this Mass at 8 o'clock, but we also have a 6:30 Mass in the evening as well. If you would like to go to that, I encourage you to sign up online if you're able to. That gives us a sense of how many people are going to be coming, because we do have a limit on the inside here. And we want to make sure that we're able to accommodate. If we fill up our limit here, then those that maybe are not on that list might have to wait outside. We can bring communion out and have our radio on so you can hear, but we have a certain limit within here. So please sign up online so that we'll know who to expect. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks
be to God. As we pray the St. Michael Prayer, let's pray it especially for all of those that lost their lives in Pearl Harbor. This is one of those anniversaries that's easy for us to, over the years, to forget. But just like September 11th, is something very much in our memory. It's important for us to remember all of those that suffered, that died during that time, which was a terrible tragedy within our country. And let's pray especially, we can remember possibly the Christmas that maybe they had, those that had lost loved ones, and they had to really go deep into that Christmas mystery of the light of Christ. I'm sure that was a very difficult Christmas for them, and not unlike the difficult Christmas of this time, of 2020, but those are those moments in which we draw strength, not from the material things of this life, but that we hold on to Christ, who came to truly bring us a peace that the world cannot give, and even when we are suffering, can still experience the deep peace and joy of the light of the world. So we pray, Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the divine power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to your protection, implored your help, or sought your intercession, was left unaided. Inspired by this confidence, I fly to you, O Virgin of Virgins, my Mother. To you do I come, before you I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in your mercy,